What's going on, everyone? These people are mowing their lawn outside. I don't know what they're doing, but they have a job, so I gotta respect their grind. But I haven't really talked about the iPhone XR of 2019, the iPhone XR 2. I've talked about the original one a lot. Obviously, you guys probably seen all my videos about it. But today on leaks, and I guess they collaborate a lot with other people, they presented some of their leaks, you know, some of their findings, some of their renders of what they think the iPhone of XR of 2019 is going to be. And I feel like they're on the right track. Obviously, I'm just a small guy. I have no idea what I'm talking about. But based off what I'm thinking, I mean, obviously, they're probably more right. But I think Apple might take a different approach. I feel like they're actually going to go with the black design. It's still the same concept. But I feel like on the back, there's going to be a little bit of a difference. So they had it on their design of their render that it's going to be pretty much like the flatness of it. It's going to be pretty much like the same color for the lens and around the lens as well. But I personally think that Apple might just actually go and just put a black thing on the back of this where like the square camera hump is. So I guess they're going to keep that blackness around this lens. It's not going to match the iPhone XR back color. It's going to be black, in my opinion. And the reason I say that is because I feel like that's a super premium feature that makes the iPhone look really, really nice. I feel like they're going to save that specific thing for the better iPhone XS and XS Max or iPhone 11, whatever that is. I feel like they're going to save that for those. I don't know why they would put that on this one. I mean, I feel like it's like 50-50. That's kind of a small thing. They're still going to put a dual camera sensor on it, in my opinion. So it's a pretty big upgrade coming from like at this single camera sensor you had on this thing. But in terms of their render, they could be potentially right. And I feel like they might be more right than I am. But that is just my opinion, something that they could potentially do. And shout out to OnLeaks, man. They really inspired a whole new generation of people making leaks and stuff, just like me, or just making renders. So OnLeaks, if you're watching this, let's do a collaboration. The fans want it, all right? It's not me saying it, everybody else is saying it. In terms of performance, obviously it's going to get the newest chipset and all that stuff, but on the front, you guys might be a little bit sad about this. They actually might keep the same exact, pretty much every single thing else about this phone the same. It's still going to have probably the same type of feeling on the sides, that same 6S Plus feeling on the bezel around it. It's going to have thicker bezels on the front. The same 6.1-inch display, it's still going to be 750p. I don't see why they would increase or decrease the resolution of it. They're going to be exactly the same. Most potentially, they're going to add a new color selection as well. But that's pretty much where I'm seeing these things lay out. I feel like for them to still keep that whatever $750 price tag, which is still super expensive for this phone, they're not going to necessarily cut corners, but they're just going to keep the same thing going because it's worked for them before. The iPhone XR is their best-selling iPhone, so I don't feel like as of right now, not like of all time, so I don't necessarily feel like why they would just go ahead and change things if it's already working. They're not going to change it too drastically. Of course, it's going to be faster, it's going to be this, it's going to be that, but ultimately, the back camera is going to be the biggest upgrade for the iPhone XR, in my opinion. The battery size might get a little bit of an increase. There's been rumors and reports saying that the iPhone XR right now is not getting the same amount of suggested battery life that Apple has suggested or Apple says it's going to get. So maybe they'll increase the battery there to make it a little bit more accurate according to their statements or something, who knows. I could also see Apple still selling the original iPhone XR possibly while they're selling the iPhone XR 2 because they're going to have to keep some newer iPhones there. And if they eventually make the SE 2, then that will pretty much take the iPhone XR's place. But since they're not selling the iPhone X, they're going to have to either get rid of the XS and XS Max or get rid of the iPhone XR. And I feel like they would rather keep the iPhone XR there and get rid of the XS and XS Max and vice versa. So that's kind of where I'm sitting at. But those are some new revelations about the iPhone XR 2. If you guys have any questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit that like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it would mean so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel, all those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.